It's Brian Preston, the Money Guy.
All right, this first one is from Dan O'Halloran. Hey, can you speak to donor-advised funds? I want to become more organized about my giving this year. I think that's a great goal in 2021. What are your thoughts? Is it beneficial to the charities I support and not just myself? So maybe what is a donor-advised fund? How does it work? And is it only good for me or is it good for the charity as well? And then I'll kind of sprinkle in some benefits.
I love donor-advised funds. I think that if you are charitably minded, this is the way to supercharge your generosity. Mm-hmm. And it is, by the way, a win-win situation for both you as well as the charity. And let me explain kind of how these things work. A little history lesson. Back in the past, if you wanted to give appreciated holdings to a charity, you had to go through a lot of steps, meaning that first you had to convince your charity, go open up a brokerage account mm-hmm. with, you know, one of the big wirehouses, and then you could give primarily only appreciated stock. So if you owned stock of a company that was traded, you could give that appreciated company to and donate it by transferring it to the brokerage account of the charity.
Yeah.
We've gone, once again, innovation, technology, and just the modern world we live has made everything so much better, so much easier. Because a lot of us, I always used to think about the fact, I don't do a lot of individual stocks. I'm more of a mutual fund
investor.
What do I do?
Yeah.
You know, and then I don't want to go ask my local church or my local, charity for the animals that I care for. I don't want them to feel like they have to go open a brokerage account
right.
just so I get a tax benefit. It's gotten so much better because now what has happened with these donor advised funds, and the ones we're very familiar with is like Fidelity Investments has one,
yep.
Charles Schwab has one. You can donate mutual funds. You can donate anything pretty much that's in these accounts that's appreciated. And here's the cool thing for the charities. They absolutely do not have to open any accounts. Now they just get checks.
They get a check.
I mean, they just get a check, no different than if you were writing a check with a checkbook. But here's why it's a win-win for everybody involved. When you have appreciated holdings, you know it, and I'm going to give a simple investment. Let's just say that you bought Tesla a year and a half ago. And I mean, seriously,
no,
you bought it, you know,
you paid
$100 for it. It's now worth $1,000.
Sure.
You've decided you want to be charitably minded and give that $1,000 of Tesla stock to your donor advised fund. What's great is that you've got $900 of capital gain mm-hmm. that you don't want to pay income tax on. Well, so you donate it to the donor advised fund. You don't pay any income tax. You just donated $1,000, $900 of appreciation that's never going to be taxed. You're going to get a charitable contribution of a full $1,000.
Yep.
Not $100, not what you paid, as long as it was 12 months of holdings. Mm-hmm. It's got to be long-term, by the way. You're going to get a credit for $1,000. The donor-advised fund is going to sell that Tesla stock and then send a check. If you go in there and say, hey, I want this to go to my church, I want this to go to my animal charity, you will automatically, you know, they will then send mm-hmm. a check for $1,000. That's going to be no different than you stroking them
yep.
a check, but now you get the charitable deduction, plus you didn't ever pay the capital gain tax. It's a win-win, and they get the money.
Can I tell you two things that I love about donor advised funds? It makes the process, in my opinion, of giving a lot more easy and streamlined. I know that I used to, like, I'd have a nephew that wanted me to donate to something, and then I'd have this cause over here. And through the course of the year, I'd have, you know, 50s and 100s and all these things all over the
mm-hmm.
place. And then when it come tax time, I'd be like, oh, man, I got to go remember all the things that I did, or I had to put them in a shoebox. The beautiful thing when it comes to like filing your taxes is when you have a donor advised fund, rather than having to go collect all those receipts, you only have to keep up with one number. How much did I put into the fund? So even if you made a one-time contribution of $1,000, but you had it go in $100 to 10 different organizations, from a tax standpoint, all you care about is that one contribution of the $1,000. It just makes tax filing a whole lot more simple. And the other thing that I think is great is now you can even set up recurring donations. So even if you are someone who wants to give to a church on a monthly or weekly basis, you can actually have your donor advised fund set up to do that automatically. So it just makes that process a whole lot easier, a whole lot more streamlined. It makes tax time at least just a little bit less stressful.
One quick statement on kind of a tax hack
mm-hmm.
That I do. If you are charitably minded every year, it's not just a one-time thing because you had one appreciated holding. Like if you're a tither to your church, there is another level that I'd like people to understand. And this is something I practice personally, is that one of the problems when you start investing in after-tax money is you're going to notice when you're successful at it, is that, yes, you have this after-tax account that you're kind of earmarked for your future, for retirement, but it's kind of hard to get access to the money because it's now getting to be too appreciated. Anytime you touch that money, you're going to pay income taxes on it. Here's what I like, is that I give every month to my church, but I'm doing that through the Charitable Advised Fund, but then every month I'm replacing by buying. I'm dollar cost averaging into the same investments that I'm now donating, and it's replenishing. And guess what it's doing? When I'm getting rid of the lower basis holdings and rebuying at the higher price, I'm slowly raising the basis in my taxable account. So it actually creates another, a fourth benefit of is that I actually get easier access to my after-tax investments if I ever so needed to get into that account.
That's a great point.
So that's kind of extra level. That's advanced planning, but it's something if you're charitably minded. And by the way, this is probably a last plug on the abundance cycle with that is that if you get into those advanced things and you just want to nerd out on best ways to do it, that's when it probably does, might want to have somebody like a financial planner that can work through some of those charitable goals on the, in an advanced stage so that you make sure that you're taking care of everything and there's not any blind spots to the plan.
Love it.